I found out the concept that that's night I can stay.
It's a bot game.
Two months after, I got into EOS. First, I got into the Telegram group, for sure.
And then the connection point is, he helped translate the shit to my white paper, which is how he and That's how the community
I translated Shintai White Spirit into Spanish and into Chinese.
Nice.
And then after, like, I think one week later, and then they reached out to me, let's just form a team and let's try to become a rock producer, let's just try this out. And
I said it more than I said, let's win.
Then we started from there. That's kind of my story in this year. But today is this fucking history, man. I can be able to connect with all of you, which is like just really
You know what it is for me? The possibility to create a more fair, equitable world for the underbanked, for the underprivileged. Mm-hmm. As somebody who had a heroin addict father and an alcoholic mother and didn't have a lot of opportunities, you know what I'm saying, to be able to get upward mobility. And be a part of a community that believes in me, you know, and sees my value.
Reach.
Oh, yeah.
You
see your value.
Yeah. Guys.
guys, I cannot believe it. It almost feels like surreal because, you know, there's two Chinese friends and they might be the farthest the country who flew over from to witness this moment, right? I'm second farthest. I'm from Korea. I'm a baby candidate. You smart one. Because we are all one. Actually, how I get into this crypto was kind of crazy. Because 2012, there's this one guy named Tony Liu. He came to me because I was an accelerator back then. Hey, I want to build a crypto exchange. The first crypto exchange in Korea. There's just one person, right? We were thinking, what's a crypto? What is Bitcoin? Right? That's how I first heard the term, right? And then we ended up gave them investment. $50,000. Very small money. And then 4 years later, he sold his company at $95 million.
Ooh,
yeah. Only four years. And then when I first invested in them, I bought some Bitcoin, knowing what it's going to be, right? And then when he for the first time, he went 2,000 for the first time, I sold everything. I said, we need 5,000, right? Okay, what I'm gonna do? Fuck it, I'm just gonna keep my job. I'm just gonna go to Burning Man. Man, that's pretty much when my whole life's so fucked up.
Then you met Brock Shoes.
Literally. And then, yeah, so in Burning Man, I somehow meeting Brock in Korea in the first EOS meetup in the Charlie Chaplin video, you remember, right? Yeah, that one. And then I decided, I felt it's not logic, it's not intellect.
It's hard.
I felt so deep thing is happening through EOS. So, we all feel it. It's all about making oneness.
Yep.
So I so felt seeing all you guys. Oh my fucking god, this is totally achievable.
Yeah,
this is beautiful, amazing people, right?
Yeah.
Every single body, I'm so blown away to be here. So I said too much. Just I love you guys. I'm so grateful to be here.
Texas of Canada, Calgary. I got into this 6 years ago. My buddy sent me a $10 tip, Bitcoin, just Bitcoin tip. I was like, what the fuck is this shit, right? Like, I was like, bro, just said, like, he actually lost a bet. He wasn't that nice. He lost a bet. He's like, bro, I'll send you the $10 over Bitcoin. I'm like, bro. Give me cash, like, what the fuck is Bitcoin?
Can't buy diamonds.
What year was this? Is what I really want.
This was like
2012.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah. I'll take that $10. And then just a year and a half ago, I like log in and it's like, it was like a few $100. I'm like, whoa. There's something, like, my mind is like, there's something here, right? So I'm like, I'm originally a developer, so I'm like, okay, I'm like, what can I do? I got into Bitcoin, I bought Bitcoin for a few months, but I was like, I'm not doing anything. So I like moved over to Ethereum. I'm like, this is a cool platform that allows me to do anything I want. It's pretty much Turing complete. I'm like making cool shit, but like, I'm making this cool shit, but the people who I'm making it for can't use it. It's like, they can't use it. Like, I'm making games, I'm like, I love game dev, I'm making games and they can't do anything but wait for their transactions to go through. Like, you don't make a game like that. Everyone knows that's not a fucking game. Like, so, and logically, I moved to EOS. And, like, just being in EOS has, like, developing just feels natural to me in EOS. And I'm really excited for what I'm going to make and what all of you guys are going to make. Because as Kevin said, it's all about what we're going to make.
We're going to make on this.
That's where the real value is going to come from, the stuff that we make for this chain.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Where do I even start? Short version.
Keep it short version.
My name is Kareem Machina, originally from Central African Republic, if you know what that is. Half from France. Went to Boston for college, studied engineering. I got into crypto in a funny way. My friend Mike here has been talking about crypto for the last 2 years. I'm like, dude, I'm busy. I can't do this. You know, I'm making six figures. I'm working hard. I'm trying to change my life. I'm trying to change my family's life. If you ever read the book from Malcolm Gladwell, Outliers, that's the story of my life. I have seen it all. I have AK-47 pointing to my head. I've seen war. I've seen the craziest shit. I don't even know how I got here, but I made a vow to just, I'm just going to make it happen. I'm going to be the one that's going to carry everybody on my back. And I was just like so focused. And then Bitcoin hit 5K. And I'm like, okay,
same moment.
What's over there? You know, in my book, kudos to him. He keep pushing. He keep pushing. And he sent me a statement with six figures. I'm like, okay, not going to pay attention. And then got into crypto, bought some Bitcoin. That's cool. But the most amazing thing is I dig deep. And I'm like, damn, I'm sending money back home. And I pay fucking 10% Western Union, some bullshit. I'm waiting 2 weeks. People can't pay their bills. Wow. Those motherfuckers don't work on the weekends. I'm like, this is beyond money. This can actually change the world. And then, you know the saying, you go down the rabbit hole, you find out about everything, and then EOS, and then the community. I remember when Nathan James first got to the chat, and I'm like, who's doing this thing? I'm like, yeah, have you heard about Metamax? Yeah, and then boom, he made it better. I remember when you dropped the white paper.
I was like one of the first
in the group, and I'm like, this is what I've been yearning for, a community, family. Yeah. My dad used to say to me, no matter what you do, son, it's not about how much you make, it's how you make your money and who you're around. And for that, I'll be forever grateful to the community, which is the reason why I'm here. Again, Brock Pierce, when I saw the saying about Ikigai, I had tears. It's just like one of those things where you can't control and you just get moved. You're not doing work, you're just like, what's up with the community? How can I help somebody? Like, what's going on? Like, you just get so distracted. And I want to make a vow today.